Hello, and welcome to Lutz and Glory. I'm Bronwyn.
I'm Will.
Kathy could not make this podcast, unfortunately. As you guys can notice, she is not here. However, we opened up our podcast to include a guest spot to one of the people who watch our podcast, one of our fans, if you will. And that is when we found our special guest. Would you like to introduce yourself?
All right. So my name is Kanishka. I've been following skating since the 2001 World Championships. My favorite skaters are Michelle Kwan, Jeremy Abbott, and the list just continues to grow. And I'm so excited that Lutz and Glory chose me to be part of their podcast. So thank you.
We're very excited to have you on. I've talked to Kanishka before. He's very knowledgeable. He's very fun to talk to. So I feel like this is going to be a great recap. So let's dive into Skate America. We're going to start off with the ladies. The winner of this event, what were your thoughts?
I'll start. Medvedeva obviously taking the title. Really, just mind-boggling technique. She can just rattle off triples like they are singles. It's really unbelievable. She is just, you know, we've heard it so many times, she's just part of this crop of Russian ladies who are just able to just tick off these jumps. In competition, they are totally unfazed by the pressure. This, lest we forget, was her first senior competition, or not her first senior competition, but it was her first senior Grand Prix and her second senior competition, her first being the Andre Nepala Trophy. I mean, she was just lights out in the short program, and she just had kind of that fluke fall in the long program. I think she still has a lot of room to grow artistically, though. No, the thing that I noticed about both of her programs was that stylistically they were kind of similar. And what you really want to see in a skater is that they have versatility and they're able to adapt to change and they're able to push themselves out of their comfort zone and think outside the box. And I think, you know, I don't want to be too critical because it is only her first senior season and this getting a 206 at your first senior Grand Prix and beating an Olympic medalist, a reigning world medalist. You know, I mean, it's just really, really, really great stuff. So, yeah, what are your thoughts, Kanishka?
All right. So, Evgenia Medvedeva, I thought that she looked really, really strong in the short program. I feel like she could work on her presentation still, but I guess she is still really, really young. So that'll probably come with time. I kind of wish that ISU would probably come up with a rule that says, like, you can only do a certain number of jumps with her hands over her head, because it comes off a little distracting, but I thought that her jumps were on point and that she has a lot to grow from this competition, for sure.
I agree. Of all the Russian, like, the younger Russians who are just breaking into senior ranks, I feel like she is one of the most expressive. She does actually pay attention to her music, and she has some lovely facial expression as well throughout her programs. I just feel like her programs, music-wise, does not really do her any favors. It's a little one note, and it doesn't really work for her. However, I feel that she has all the potential to actually become quite artistic in the future. I think she is very lovely to watch, and she also has that technical base, so I feel like in the future, she is going to be a star. I think we're seeing the beginnings of someone who could really dominate in the future, if she can keep this up.
For sure, and I definitely think that, like, her technique has longevity, or potential for longevity. It's not, you know, we've seen it with this type of demise with skaters like Livnitskaya, who finished sixth here. The technique is just not there. I mean, it helped her when in Sochi, you know, obviously. But as she's been growing, she's definitely experienced some trouble there. But I think Yevgenia's technique is so sound that it'll definitely last for a while, and it'll always keep her in the mix. Another skater that also has a very strong technical base is reigning national silver medalist Gracie Gold, who came in second here. You know, I was really proud of Gracie here, I have to say. She put together, I mean, despite the double flip in the short program, she put together two really strong programs. Honestly, I think these are her two best programs to date. In terms of choreography. I really like her step sequence in the short program. But again, we see this issue time and time again from Gracie. It just, there needs to be more in the face. There just needs to be more. It can't, you can still be focused. It's really tough. It's really tough. But, you know, she's been on the scene for a while, and she's really, you know, this is a great, great step in the right direction for her. She's exceeded 200. She's crossed that threshold. She's finally in that upper echelon, I think. But, you know, it'd just be really nice to see her even, you know, do a Janet Lynn where you can fall down and get up and smile. And I don't think, I think she needs the jumps to be able to really express something genuine and really make the audience connect to her. But I mean, that technique is just amazing. The Lutz toe in both programs was just fabulous. So I'm really proud of her, and I think she's definitely put the pressure on other American ladies to make this, making this world team a really tough challenge. What are your guys' thoughts?
I absolutely agree. Her Lutz toe was kind of, not to say missing in action, but she struggled much more with it this season. And you can see, like, at events like the World Team Trophy at Nationals, she kept getting really close to the boards. And it looked like she was lucky that she didn't actually hit the boards. But this year, her Lutz toe, she had so much room between her and the boards, and it was fire. It was her money combination. I was incredibly impressed with her technical firepower, especially in the free program. That was an one of her best performances by far. Artistically, she still does have more room to grow. Her Firebird, it has potential. It absolutely has potential. Just some of the choreography I'm not a fan of. And, like, she does have issues with her arms, where they do tend to be straight, and they turn into airplane arms. I'd like to see her watch someone like Tatsuki Michita, who's Firebird. He has the most polished arms and the most gorgeous line. I'd love for her to find Firebirds like that or other programs like that and take cues from that, because she could definitely do very well with this program. I'm just not a huge fan right now, but I could see it getting a lot better in the program. Or in the future.
Yeah, I agree with what both of you have said. Like, I feel like these are her strongest programs to date, both the short program and the long program. She seems to be really into the short program as well, so it seems like something that she loves to skate. Like, last season, we could tell that Phantom of the Opera was not for her.
And even the short program, which was recycled, you could tell she was, like, tired of it. And so were we, you know? It's like, if the skater's not into their programs, how are we going to be into it? I'm sorry, continue.
All good, yeah, exactly. And I think that's kind of where we always want to see Gracie at, like, where she loves her programs and she can just skate how she normally skates. And I think this season will be a breakthrough season for her, because the programs are well-constructed. She seems to have her jumps back together, and it's all a confidence thing with her. And I think with confidence, the emotions will come out. And I'm looking forward to seeing what Gracie can. I'm looking forward to seeing what Gracie has in store for all of us this season.
For sure, the bronze medalist from Skate America, the reigning world silver medalist Satoko Miyahara from Japan. She has such a diminutive stature, but you wouldn't think it on TV. She skates so big, you know? I definitely think that she still has to work on her outward projection, like her total connection to the audience and her total awareness of where she is on the ice and in relation to the audience, you know? But, I mean, her programs this year are just stunning. I love her short program is so dynamic, and it's so well choreographed. You know, she had some technical issues here, nothing major. But a major thing that a lot of people have been talking about with Satoko is that she isn't really getting the program component scores that she deserves. And I actually, I think that the program component scores that she received at Skate America in both the short program and the free program were her highest program component scores ever in an IGS competition. And I think that's definitely noteworthy, because these judges are finally appreciating her presence and finally seeing her talent, you know? I mean, obviously they saw it last season too, but I think they're really rewarding her. They're going to start to reward her even more for that this season. I also love our short program dress, the long program dress. We could use a little work. It's a little too pink for my taste, but you know, really great job. I think a good start to the season for her.
No, I agree completely. Her short program is one of my favorite programs of the season so far. She is definitely getting there as terms of, like, getting the PCS. I do feel that in comparison, well, the placements were 100% correct, but in comparison to, like, someone like Yevgenia or Gracie, I feel like her PCS could absolutely be higher than theirs, just because she is the more complete skater in terms of PCS. However, she is definitely getting a step in the right direction, and you can tell she's improved on her expression to the audience as well, especially in her short program. There were some times where she was on fire, and I could feel it.
Yeah, that little smirk, that little, like,
yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Completely agreed. And there are some very lovely moments in her long program, too. The ending spiral is just fabulous. But while I do think the placements were right, I would like to see her just be scored fairly in PCS compared to the people she's skating against.
For sure.
Yeah, I think in the short program, one of the commentators on Ice Network actually said that she's normally a really shy girl on and off the ice, but she was making eye contact with certain people in the audience, and I think that's a step in the right direction for her because it'll allow her to make connections with the audience and perhaps even the judges, and that might result in higher PCS scores in the future. And I love her long program. I love the music, so a little biased there, but because of her music and her style, you just can't help but cheer Satoko on in every way.
For sure. Another person who's really easy to cheer on is the fourth place finisher here at Skate America, Elizabeth Tursunbaeva, representing Kazakhstan. It's really great to see another Kazakh in the mix. You know, I'd say she placed about where I expected her to. You know, a solid upper 170s score, fourth place. I think this is exactly where she needs to be. I really like both of her programs. But, you know, I think, again, she kind of has the same problem as Medvedeva in terms of the fact that both of her programs are similar in terms of the purpose and the emotion you have to evoke. You know, it doesn't really require too much departure from one another, you know? But I think her jumping technique is fabulous. She does a weird thing, though, where I don't know, it just, sometimes when she gets up into the jump, her legs take a little while to get together, but once it's together, it's tight, it's clean, it's fast, and really, really great to see. So yeah, definitely really proud of her here, and just another one of those, pupils of Brian Orser. He's just been able to churn out, great skaters over the years. Also really nice to see her fight back after the short program, finished fourth in the free skate and clawed her way up to fourth overall. So what are you guys' thoughts on Elizabeth?
I was fortunate enough to see Elizabeth skate live at Skate Detroit this July, and there's something about her live that really draws you in that you can't it doesn't translate well to video. She is a lovely skater to watch. I really enjoy watching her skate. I feel that in the future, she is also someone like Yevgenia, who could really be a big star. It's just right now she needs to work on getting there, but right now she is also where she needs to be right now. What are your thoughts, Kanishka?
She kind of reminds me of a young Yuna Kim. Not just the body type, but her music, Papa Can You Hear Me? Like, Yuna Kim skated to that as well. Mm-hmm. And she's coached by Brian Orser. I don't know if that's just coincidence or not, but if she's heading in that same direction as Yuna Kim, we could be looking at her on the Olympic podium one day. So, And she's so young that she has the spring in her legs to make anything a triple-triple if she wanted it to be.
Mm-hmm.
So I think this is a skater to watch out for in the future, yeah, for sure.
That triple sal, triple toe that she did in the free, like, I didn't think it was going to happen. But she, not only did she execute it, but it was gorgeous. Like, yeah, really just innate jumper. Another person who I think is a fabulous jumper is the person who rounded out the top five here at Skate America, Karen Chen, the reigning U.S. bronze medalist. I love both of her programs this year. I just think, just like Satoko, she may be small in stature, but boy, she can really just emote and connect, and I think she just has so, so much potential. Again, just like Elizabeth, I think Karen's right where she needs to be. Top five at your first senior Grand Prix is a really, really great place to be. Both of her programs, again, it's big, somewhat overpowering music, but I think come nationals, she'll really be able to live up to you know, just all the crescendos and all the dynamics and all of her music. Especially if she skates clean, and just every time she does a spiral, it is just pure magic. It is so gorgeous, and it's always so beautifully timed, so she is certainly one to watch. What are your guys' thoughts on Karen?
Yeah, I love her skating so much. She is not only she can carry powerful music. I was initially very skeptical of her using Turando for her short program, but she proved me wrong. She definitely disproved all my doubts, because she can carry that music so well. And not only that, she's artistic and she's a huge jumper. That triple Lutz, one of the best in the world.
Yeah.
It's huge and it's clean. It's gorgeous. I love it. I do think that she is also right where she needs to be. I think that she will do very well on the Grand Prix this season, I hope, in her second event, which I believe is Cup of China. And she's just someone who, again, Skate America was an event of these future stars, in my opinion. I think a lot of these skaters, if they keep on the trajectory that they are on right now, are the future of this sport. And I think I'm very impressed with what I saw this weekend at Skate America. If these, if people like Yevgenia, Elizabeth, and Karen are the future of the sport, then I will be very excited to see where this goes.
Yeah, I think Karen answers the question, like, where's that jump in that jump? And she just flies into that triple Lutz, triple toe in the short program. And I think you could tell, like, she covers so much ice going into it. And the name of the game for Karen in particular is just to, like, stay focused and land those jumps. Because in the past, she would struggle in her jumps in when it comes to the competition, with the exception of Nationals last season. So I hope that she builds up on her momentum that she can build from Skate America. And, yeah, she's definitely a wild card as far as Nationals go, especially this season with what she did last season at Nationals. So hopefully she builds on the momentum of skating really well here and takes it on to the next Grand Prix and then Nationals. So.
For sure. Outside of the top five, I think there are three stories that we really want to focus on here, those of Lipnitskaya, Nicole Raichova, and Mariah Bell. Let's start with Lipnitskaya. It's tough because we know how talented she is. We really do. And just last year was somewhat of a disaster for her, especially at Russian Nationals. I mean, it was really, really tough to see. And I remember, I think, didn't she talk about switching coaches from Ater? I thought she had switched coaches, but I guess she stuck to Ateri. You know, I think her programs this year, they're not bad, but they're kind of forgettable.
I agree.
You know, and I don't know. I really hope she does improve because she's so talented. And, you know, I don't know if we'll ever see her in Sochi form again, but if she can gets somewhere near there, she'll be able to contend with these Russians like Medvedeva, who just keep rising from the ranks. So we'll see. What are your guys' thoughts on Lutnitskaya?
I completely agree with what you said. I don't know if these programs are the best vehicle for her. Her famous Schindler's List long program was an example of excellent packaging. And this season, I'm left confused by her packaging, especially in the short program. With the Elvis medley and the rainbow dress, I'm like, what are you doing? Like, I'm not trying to be rude. I'm just really confused right now. And I feel like she is extremely talented. However, her technique, it's kind of a case of, like, she got the technique, but because she was so small and she could rotate so quickly, she could do the jumps, but now that she's older, she's grown, she's had a growth spurt, the technique has started to fall apart on her, and it's very sad to watch, especially to see someone who has won multiple Grand Prix events and a European's title fall to six in this event here, when she was looking for a podium finish, absolutely. However, I hope she can get it back together. I hope she can continue to improve. But right now I'm a little bit hesitant because I don't know. There's so many new people coming up and rising, especially in Russia. She was going to want to improve on that ninth place finish back in Russian Nationals, but there's so many new seniors in the ranks that I don't know.
Yeah, I was very confused when I first saw her short program. I was like, how old is she now? I don't know. She's really young and skating to Elvis Presley. And I was like, Marina, what were you thinking? But she's a really dark Russian, so I was hoping that they would pick something more like dark Russian-esque kind of music for her.
I feel like Dark Eyes, something like Dark Eyes would be great for her. I think she would be great with interpreting something like that. Continue.
Yeah, because the music that they chose for her are not what I would expect from Yulia Lipnitskaya, and I think, like what you guys mentioned, like her technique is just starting to falter on her now. Her body is obviously changing, and I'm not saying that she's out of shape, but I feel like she can't just rely on her old technique, and I'm not sure whether that's why she needs a coaching change or she just needs a new direction or just another season to just revamp her jumping technique. But she seems to be in a similar situation to Caroline Zhang, where she came off so young and so good, and then as she got older and her body started changing, she needed to really fix up her technique. So I'm hoping that she can fix up her technique and that she gets consistent and gets back into the form that we know she could. And yeah, right now I'm left a little puzzled as far as her future is concerned. So
definitely. Two skaters, though, that I think definitely made an impact here at Skate America were Nicole Rajcheva of Slovakia and Mariah Bell of the United States. Rajcheva it was so funny. She was the first skater out of the gate since she finished last in the short program, and she was just lights out perfect in the free. It was just really, really great to see, and we were like, wow, if this is the first free skate, how are the other ones going to stack up? So definitely great debut, or not debut, but season debut for Rajcheva here. And Mariah Bell, I think with Mariah, this was definitely a good event for her because she finished, where was she this summer that she finished 13th or this fall? Was that Andre? I think it was Andre Nepala. It wasn't good. And, you know, I really like her short program, and I definitely think her long program has potential. So I think here at Skate America, it's like, you got to do something now. I know it's really early in the season for her, but we need second-tier skaters like Mariah, not in terms of quality, but in terms of how they've done and their accolades up to this point, you know? I think skaters like her need to start proving themselves to not only international judges, but to fans and possibly domestic judges now. It needs to start now. So I definitely think that here at Skate America, she had a great rebound from the way she started the way her preseason went. What are your guys' thoughts on those two skaters?
So I have a friend who lives up in Colorado and has been to Monument, where Mariah trains, and she's been struggling a little bit in practice, and I was so proud of her to see her go into that triple flip, triple toe in the short program and nail it and get positive GOEs on that triple combination, because it's one that's kind of still new to her. But when Mariah has that fire in her eyes, you can trust her, and she just needs to continue believing in herself and just keep going after the triple-triple and just staying focused throughout the entire program. She showed it yesterday in the free skate that she can come back from one mistake and continue the program. And if that's the kind of what we expect from these second-tier skaters, to really just come out and perform. And if she can do that, she could see herself being top five at Nationals, because this is her only Grand Prix for the season. So, yeah, go Mariah.
I agree. All right, let's move on to pairs. That was a very interesting event. Wen Jingsui and Song Han winning the event. However, they didn't win the short program, and that was probably the biggest shocker of the event. Alexa Shimeka and Chris Kinnearum actually won the short program, the first to win since 2006, the short program. I thought they were very good. What are your guys' thoughts on Alexa and Chris?
You know, I thought this was really great. You know, they started really at the tail end of last season, was when they started their upward trajectory. Especially at World Team Trophy, they beat Kabaguri and Smirnov in the free skate and clinched that gold medal for North America there. You know, they're just so technically proficient. I think, you know, they still need to work on their side-by-side jumps, but everything is just big. It's huge. And they're just so determined and so ready to prove themselves this season. I think getting a 190 plus, we haven't really seen that from an American pair in a while, you know? So I think they're one of the first American teams to really show that they have the potential to finish top five at Worlds, possibly even medal, especially if others falter. Their short, I think their short program is spot on in terms of their skating style. I think it's aggressive, it's feisty, I don't know, I really like it a lot. The free program isn't my favorite. It's not my cup of tea, but I think it definitely has potential. I like the ending. It builds. It's dynamic. It changes. There's change. It keeps you interested. So I definitely think, especially by Nationals, they'll be looking to prove themselves. You know, just great to come out, win that short program, and hang on to that silver medal. Really, really great to see. What are your thoughts, Kanishka, on them?
All right. So I love Alexa and Chris. So I'm not being biased, but I love Metallica as well. So when they when I found out that they're skating to Metallica for their short program, I was like, good. And then she always gives face. Like, you can't stop but look at Alexa's face. No offense to Chris, but like, it's all about Alexa in this team. And they just brought it in that short program. And their long program, it's also not my favorite, but I think the packaging is right for this team. And if they continue to skate these programs clean, I could see them being the next Ina and Zimmerman, who were like one of our top teams back in the day. So, yeah.
No, I agree. I really like the short program. It does lose me during the step sequence. I feel like it could be much sharper because then I really want to like the program, but it loses me a bit in the middle, and then I'm like, you had me going. Come on. Mm-hmm. But that said, I love her costume, especially in the short program. Mm-hmm. The ponytail and the jumpsuit, I love it.
And the makeup, too.
And the makeup, yes, I love it. She looks great. Mm-hmm. They look very good. It is, so I just thought it was a huge achievement in itself just to win the short program at a Grand Prix event. That's huge. And I think even though they didn't do so well in the long program, I think they have a great start to their season because there's nowhere to go but up from here, in my opinion.
I think another team that had a fabulous season debut was the Canadian team, Seguin and Bilodeau. Two just lovely programs. What I admire so much about them is that, though they're a young team, they have such connection with each other and with the audience and with the music, and I just think they have this sort of coolness and this sort of sophistication. They skate like seniors, and, you know, it's really, really great stuff. I love both of their programs. I think they're a really well-packaged team as well. Great score, approaching 190. That's a really, really nice score to see this early on in the season, especially from them. They have the technique. They've got it all, I think. What are your guys' thoughts on them?
I agree. I love this pair. They have to be one of my favorite up-and-coming pairs this season. I think that they are both lovely skaters, and I especially love their long program for them. It's perfect for their style, and I think they are both going to be, excellent in the future. I think this was an amazing start for them, and I was really glad because I know Julianne used to do singles, and I know for a while it was kind of unsure, would she go with singles, would she go with pairs, and it seems like she's gone with pairs, and I am thrilled that these two are here to stay. And on a side note, their triple twist is gigantic. I feel like they could, in the future, they could easily do a quad, so okay. I'm thinking that we should keep our eyes out for that, absolutely.
I also think that they have, like, they just love to skate. Like, I was, instead of watching just the skating, I was watching their facial expressions, and they were always smiling throughout the program, mm-hmm. and that really makes you invest more in their skating. So I definitely see great things for them, because they seem to enjoy the whole process of skating, and it's not just seems like a job that they have to do, so.
Definitely. It's never put on. It's always genuine. It's never contrived. It's really great to see. Another big story of Skate America were the two big names coming in. I think objectively they were the two front runners coming into Skate America were the fourth place finishers, Ksenia Stobova and Fedor Klimov, and the winners, Wenjing Sui and Song Han. Let's start with the Chinese pair. When I saw the videos from the test event, the domestic competition, I fell in love with the short program. It highlights every single nuance of the music. It is fiery, but it's like, it's not too much. It's like the slightest bit reserved, and it's just like, it's like that quiet, like, aggression, and it is so awesome. And I love how they both of them work together to bring the program alive. They're magnetic. You can't take your eyes off of them. And the choreography, I think, honestly, this is one of Lauren Nichols' best. The choreography in the short program is just fantastic. It is so good. And, you know, they had that invalidated spin and still weren't too far behind Alexa and Chris after the short, so I think they're really starting to make that climb. Judges really love them, and rightfully so. And their free skate to Samson and Delilah also has that quiet aggression, that fire, and they're so easy to watch. They're so fun. They leave you wanting more when you finish watching one of their programs. What are your guys' thoughts on the Chinese pair?
I just want to say that they are the perfect example of how far good technique can bring you. Song Han is only 5'7", and they can do gigantic throws and twists. And sometimes we'll see people, like, with a huge height difference or the huge, really tall guy, and they'll still struggle with the throws and the twists, but not this pair. I love their skating. They are probably my favorite pair right now. I think that they are definitely challengers for the world title this year, absolutely. And honestly, I'm hoping that they will end up winning. I'm not predicting anything, but that's what I'm really hoping, because I love this pair. I love their programs. Their elements are amazing. They combine the artistry and the technical elements flawlessly. I'm very excited to see what the rest of this season will bring for them.
Yeah, I think the Chinese team is just strong in general. Like, from the days of Shen and Zhao, Topanga and Tong, and now this up-and-coming pair, like, they just get better and better with time. So I think, as far as the season goes, I think they just need to keep building on it. I'm kind of glad that the short program that did not go perfectly, because I believe in peaking as a skater, and they're just going to continue to peak as the season goes on. So
yeah.
I think they're in a good road ahead of them.
For sure. I like what you said about the short program, because sometimes it's kind of scary to see, like, two perfect programs right off the bat, because it's like there's nothing to build off of. And it's like, we want to see you improve, and we really want to see you peak later in the season. Not to say that it's good to mess up at all in a competition, but yeah, I definitely think there's just so much that they have going for them. A team, like I mentioned before, Stobova and Klimov struggled here. And, you know, we were seeing this. We even saw this at Andre Nepala Trophy. They struggled a bit with the technical elements, especially, you know, they struggled with the triple twist, which has been kind of a hindrance for them in the past. It was much better in the free program. But I think the major issue that I have with Stobova and Klimov is that their programs are just a bit lifeless. I mean, that's kind of extreme, but there's just not enough energy. I just don't think there's enough conviviality, you know? There's just not enough punch to it. There's just a bit lackluster in terms of performance. And I think that definitely will hopefully resolve itself once they have all their technical issues in order. But also in the free program, though, the triple-triple-double was amazing. That is so cool. It was so, so cool. And they did it in unison. That was just their marquee element, if you will, for this event. But yeah, definitely disappointing to not come away from Skate America with a medal. They'll have to win their next Grand Prix if they want any chance at making the Grand Prix final. So what do you guys think of this Russian team, and what do you think they need to improve upon to really get back to where they were in the Olympic season and last season?
I think part of the... I don't think that they are done, because obviously they are still improving. They brought in the triple toe, double toe. However, I do think that not doing Worlds last year was kind of the beginning of this slow downfall, not downfall, but, you know, this decline that they've had. And I think that they definitely need to work on it, but I'm not even sure if they really enjoy skating anymore, and it's kind of sad to see, especially from a team that was absolutely incredible at the Olympics. But it is very disappointing. I do think that there is a lot to improve on, and I really hope that they can, because there is so much to like about them, but at the same time, I'm not sure if their heart are really in it.
I also wonder if they're feeling the pressure with Tatiana and Max coming back this season. So I always question when a team of their stature comes back if the rest of their countrymen start feeling more pressure during competition. So hopefully this was just another event, and that they'll be able to continue and get back to that form that we saw in Sochi. I just have questions for what to expect from them.
Yeah, definitely. Behind them, the fifth and sixth place finishers were Wang and Wang, and Kane and O'Shea. The first team being from China, the second from the United States. Let's start with the Chinese team. You know, they finished in third at both of their Grand Prix last year. And I definitely think, because the Chinese pair field is just so deep, they got kind of lost. And we saw all those Chinese pair teams in the Grand Prix final last season, and I think it was hard for them to compete. But what I love about this team is that they're just so... They have really strong technique, as we saw in the short program. They finished third there. And they have that energy. They have that spark, that youthfulness about them. That's really nice to see, struggling in the long. But still, fifth place, definitely respectable for them. And we'll see how they improve. What are your thoughts on them?
I really enjoyed their short program. I think that they're just unlucky to come from such a strong pairs field, because in any other country they would be the leading pairs, no question. I think that their technique is also, I think that the technique that the Chinese pair schools basically teach are incredible. Their technique is also very, very good. And they have, like you talked about, Will, they have that youthful energy, and they have, there's something about them that really, it's very uplifting. That's what I felt while watching their show program. I felt very happy. It was very nice and pleasant to watch. It was definitely a team that I really enjoy, will enjoy watching in the future, but it kind of sucks that they have to compete in such a packed field.
Because 170, 177, like, doesn't really cut it, you know, especially for the world team. What do you think, Kanishka?
Well, the sport really does love its youth. So if you can bring a youthful energy, you'll probably have the audience's support for sure, and the judges as well. So to place third in the short program was probably a surprise. At least it was a surprise to me. But the fact that they showed the international judges that they're capable of being part of the elite group, that was a good stepping stone for them.
For sure. Another pair that I think is capable of being in that elite group is Kane and O'Shea. Really, really. Though their placement doesn't really suggest this, I think they really have improved a lot from last season. They have really strong technique. You know, they're attempting both of those two really difficult throw jumps, the quad sal and the triplets, in the free program. So they're just so likable. They're just such nice people, and they're so, I don't know, they have this outreach to their fans and like us. And you know, they get you behind them, you know? So we'll definitely see where they place at U.S. Nationals. I think it's going to be really interesting, especially with teams like Funda and Santillan, who had a really great showing here unexpectedly. Well, not unexpectedly, but last minute, you know.
Major props to them. Not only did they find out, like, they're a brand new team, and they had just competed the week before, and then all of a sudden, surprise, you're competing at Skate America.
Yeah.
They took way advantage of this huge opportunity. I was extremely impressed, and major, major props.
Yeah, all three of our pairs from the United States did really, really well this season, this past week. So I was really proud of all three of them, for sure.
Definitely, me too. Let's move on to the dance competition. The winners from the United States, Madison Chalk and Evan Bates, putting together really two strong programs. Sunitsuna and Kutsalapov finishing second, and Gillis and Poirier finishing in third, which is a little bit disappointing for them. What are your thoughts on the podium?
I don't think anyone was expecting anyone else but Chalk and Bates to win, to be quite honest. But that said, I think that they are really, I love their lifts. I think some of their lifts are absolutely stunning. And they definitely are one of the, I'd say probably one of the better quality teams. There's still much more to work on, as always, but they've definitely proved themselves as one of the quality teams in this field. And it's very surprising because they changed their short program about a week before the Grand Prix event, and to be able to compete it very well is very impressive. It is kind of concerning that they had to change, because this was their third short dance. It is a little bit concerning that they had to change it so many times, but to come out almost completely unprepared and nail it, I think, is very impressive to see.
Yeah, how many times do ice dance team have to, like, change their program three times? That So for them to skate the way they did at Skate America, props to them, really. Like, after hearing that they had to change it 3 times, I was like, are they going to be ready? Is the program going to have everything that we expect from a Maddie and Evan program? Because Maddie knows how to sell programs very well. So, and I was a little concerned, but I think they proved me wrong, and I don't mind backing up this team. The free dance was not my favorite, but hopefully as the season goes on, that it'll grow on me. I do love the music.
So moving on to the second place finishers. So moving on to the second place finishers, we have Victoria Sinitsura and Nikita Katalipov. And then we have our third place finishers, Piper Gillis and Paul Poirier. Kind of a surprise to see Sinitsura and Katalipov finish so high on the podium. Nobody knew what kind of shape they would really be in. They didn't even compete at the Russian test skates because he was apparently injured. But they looked very strong. Like, what a great improvement for them. What are your thoughts on Sinitsura and Katalipov?
You know, I definitely a step in the right direction for this team, the silver medal was. I think they're more together, put together than last year in terms of packaging. Because last year they had issues, especially at their Grand Prix events, and then they didn't end up making the Russian world team. But, you know, I think definitely 162 was a great score for them, and it's nice to see them in good shape. What are your thoughts, Kanishka?
I feel like a lot of the skaters, like the ice dance teams this season, are going for a very similar feel as far as the music goes. So the music was not my favorite, again, but I feel like having not competed at the World Championships last season to top it off with the silver medal here is a great thing for them. And yeah, I'm proud that they were able to come back from adversity. Like, I admire that about like a team, whether they're Russian or not. So that's my thoughts.
Yeah, I do question the choice to use Swan Lake in the short dance when, especially because Nikita is known for winning the Olympic bronze medal with his former partner, Elena Ilyanik, with a Black Swan program, and that's where I'm like, wouldn't you want to use something that doesn't make people think of your old partner? Yeah. That's where I do question, and I don't really love the free dance that much. However, they did look very nice, and they are very fast team. It's very impressive to see just how much speed they can get through the ice.
So okay. The third place team here was Piper Gillis and Paul Poirier of Canada, who skated two very innovative programs, which were obviously well received by the judges. What were your guys' thoughts on their short dance and free dance here?
I wasn't personally the biggest fan. I respect what they're trying to do, and I respect that they are going outside the box and going definitely very unique and kind of weird. But in my opinion, they do tend to be a bit much. And this is coming from someone, I actually do really like this team. I loved their Hitchcock free dance they did a couple of years ago. But these programs, they didn't grab me at all. I wasn't very impressed. I do like them, and I do, like I said, I very much respect what they are trying to do. It didn't work for me at all.
Yeah, it didn't really translate well, and I think a thing that might be a little bit discouraging for them is, you know, I had mentioned in our preview that the two front runners for gold and silver at Skate America were Chalk and Bates and Gillis and Poirier, and it must be a little bit disappointing for them to see Sinitsyna and Katsalapov really make this surge to the silver medal. So we'll see how they recover from this. You know, recover is the wrong word, because it really wasn't poor by any means. But we'll see what they do in the future.
It's also very early in the season, so with ice dance, it's very unpredictable, so yeah. Perhaps the music might change later in the season, so mm-hmm. You never know.
Another great point there about Gillis and Poirier, two teams that I really, really want to mention in this recap are the two American teams who finished fourth and fifth, respectively, Caitlin Hawaiik and Jean-Luc Baker, and Anastasia Canuccio and Colin McManus. I just think both, all four of their programs, the two each, are just lovely. I loved how... I think Gillis and Poirier are attempting to go outside the box in terms of the concept, and it may not have been executed as well as I think it could be, but I think the concept-wise, especially with Canuccio and McManus's free dance, and Hawaii and Baker's free dance, that's how you conceptualize correctly, I think. That was something Kathy had mentioned to me, and I was definitely in agreement with her there. What are your guys' thoughts on these two teams?
I completely agree with you. It's worth noting, Hawaii and Baker are skating to the theory of everything for their free dance, and there was there's another team who is skating to the same music, Nicole Orford and Asher Hill of Canada, and I fell in love with their free dance when they competed at the Autumn Classic, but I hadn't seen Hawaii and Baker's free dance yet, and I was a bit skeptical, but I feel I fell in love with that free dance too. I thought especially Jean-Luc did an amazing job of the embodying the character, not only of Stephen Hawking, but also the music. The music, it breathed. It was lovely. I loved it. I also love Orford and Hill's free dance. And basically, if you skate to the theory of everything, clearly I'm going to love you. So, In all seriousness, I was very impressed. And with Canuccio and McManus, too, the Beethoven free dance. It's another way that they, like, both teams are highlighting the men in this. And I think it works brilliantly.
For sure.
I'm very excited to see how, because we are looking to see Hawaii and Baker break into the international ranks more, whereas we are waiting to see if Canuccio and McManus break into the national ranks more. And I think these programs are both excellent starts and very good vehicles for them.
Definitely.
Yeah, we have such a deep field for ice dance here in the United States. So it'll be very competitive, definitely by nationals, to see who makes a berth on the world team. But these two teams are looking really strong for early in the season. And, yeah, Nationals is going to be one heck of a competition in ice dance. So.
For sure, definitely. I think at U.S. Nationals, the men's competition is also going to be a hot ticket. So with that, I really do want to move on to the men's discipline. Just what a competition this free skate was. We see Max Aaron winning the short program and having enough leverage from that to take the title overall. I'm really proud of Max. I really think he's shown a lot of improvement artistically. Obviously, there's a lot of room to grow. But his jumps were just money, just money. The second quad salchow in the free skate was stunning. I mean, just stunning. So I definitely think this was just awesome. And we haven't seen a senior man win a Grand Prix for the United States in a while, so that was great to see. What are your guys' thoughts on Max?
Absolutely one of the highlights of the competition for me personally. I think that this is an amazing start to him. I feel like if he can make the world team, if he can keep this up, he could challenge for top five at Worlds. But that's only if he keeps this up. Obviously, the season is long and unpredictable, so I can't say that with certainty. However, this was an amazing start for him. And you can see, he's still not the most artistic skater. I think everyone can agree on that. But he has improved so much. Like, last year, when you compare his programs from last year to this year, it's like he's a new person. He's cleaned up, and he's much less, he does much less of the hockey skating that we're used to from Max. It's very encouraging is the word I'm looking for. I'm very impressed by what he put out this weekend, and especially since he was able to beat Shoma Uno, who we will get to later on, but Max definitely proved that he can be competitive internationally.
So first I would like to give props to Philip Mills, Max Aaron's choreographer for both of his programs this season. He has definitely improved in his posture and his entire skating skills. It's not completely there, but I can see that he's heading in the right direction. I feel like his short program music is really powerful and strong, and that's definitely one of the best programs that he's ever had. Swan Lake in the skating world has been used so often, but I think this is going to be his Ashley Wagner Swan Lake transformation moment. And if he can keep up with what he did at Skate America this past weekend, I could definitely see him perhaps winning another national title and going on to the Worlds and having a top five, possibly even a world podium if he can skate those quads.
Yeah, for sure. You never really know, you know. Another skater who just had a magical, magical free skate was Shoma Uno. He wasn't able to quite garner the same amount of points that he did at Japan Open, but, I mean, certainly this free skate was nothing to scoff at. I mean, there are just so many moments in his long program that are just so, so wonderful, and he's just so watchable. He also has that, like, coolness and sophistication, and the knee bend is just wonderful. He's so cute. He's just such a little nugget. Oh, I love him. But yeah, no, I love both of his programs this season, especially his free skate. What do you guys think of him?
Shoma was another skater. Much like Karen Chen, I was skeptical of him using Turndo for his free skate, but at Japan Open, blew everyone out of the water, completely disproved me, proved me wrong, and I'm very impressed with what he has done so far. He is honestly one of my favorite skaters in the men's field right now. He just captivates you. He grabs your attention. I was on the edge of my seat watching him like, oh my god, he's going to be clean. He's skating this so well. I got really excited, and he's one of the few skaters who can really bring out that excitement for me. He's just such a great, fantastic skater to watch. His skating skills are very good. My only flaw, and I know lots of people have talked about this, but his free leg on his jumps is often really close to the ice, and one of these days I'm worried that it'll actually catch the ice and he'll fall in the landing. But if he can get that up, that's just a minor nitpick. He is fantastic, and I love some of his expression to the music. One of my favorite parts is during the Nissan Dorma part, where he's in a spread eagle and he's doing these arm movements, and it's so... I love Shoma. I think he is a fantastic skater, and I can understand why he is being pushed so hard and hyped so much.
Yeah, you cannot help but love Shoma. Like, I believe that he has the X factor, like, along with Yuzuru Hanyu, and I feel like he is going to be, if not the future, the present. I can see him building on this competition and really, like, going with it the entire season if he just skates well. Like, we have a comeback with Patrick Chan, but, like, Patrick should be watching his back with this young skater for sure.
I absolutely agree. And seriously, major props, because he did a quad at the beginning, but the quad he did in the second half was even better. That was outstanding.
Definitely. Yeah, another skater who we hope to see really get that quad solid into his arsenal is the bronze medalist here at Skate America, your favorite Bronwyn, Jason Brown of the United States, the reigning national champion. I definitely think, in terms of style, his programs this year are much better. I'm a little bit dubious of the choreography. I think it'd definitely behoove Jason to get a fresh set of eyes in the ring in terms of a choreographer. But, you know, we saw him fight back from his unfortunate pop in the combination in the short program to win the bronze medal and hopefully put himself in contention again to maybe make it to the Grand Prix final. What are your guys' thoughts on Jason?
I completely agree with them needing a new fresh set of eyes. I'm a huge fan of Jason. I have been since his senior debut. And I just think that he does really need a new choreographer, because there are some moments where the choreography just doesn't make sense to me. But his programs are better. I feel like, honestly, I do think Rohin is a good choreographer. But I do think that with a different choreographer, I think the long program would be a lot better. And this is just, I'm not trying to be rude at all, I promise. I love Jason. And I do think these programs stylistically are a good idea for him while he's working on pushing his tech content. Because his short program is very similar to his one from last year, and his long program is not very complicated in terms of the music itself. So I think that is I think it's a very good start for him. However, I absolutely would love to see him work with a new choreographer.
My heart first broke for him in the short program. I think he was hoping to just skate a clean program. He was not going for the quad. And yeah, my heart just broke for him in the short program. But as you said, Bronwyn, the program was very similar to the program he did last season. And when I first saw his short program for this season, I was like, as much as I love you, Roheen, I wish you would give him a different, stylistically different program. Mm-hmm. The long program, it's growing on me. I feel like it's kind of nice to see a departure from him to go from River Dance to what he did last season to something more lyrical. And so I kind of like the long program. And I think he just needs to really get into it even more, the long program. The short program, I hope that one day they change it, honestly. I want to see something different from Jason. I love Jason, by the way, Bronwyn. I'm not hating on him at all. I really like his long. I wish the short program was a little different. But whether it's a new choreographer or just a different piece of music, mm-hmm. I would love to see a change in style, for sure.
No, yeah. I completely agree. And just to mention one thing really quick, there are still some moments that make me go, wow, in Jason's programs. There's the transition into the first spin, I believe, as a split jump into a lunge into a sit spin. And I was just like, wow, that is amazing. And then in the long program, although he does kind of overdo it on the spirals, they are very good spirals. If you're going to do a lot of spirals, you better make sure they are good. And he does extremely good spirals. It's just some of the other moments where I'm like, this doesn't make sense with what the music is saying.
Definitely. Yeah, I liked what you mentioned, Kanishka, about how the long program music has been very different this year. But I think the issue is the choreography itself hasn't really shifted that much. You know, I think Roheen has, his set of, off-the-mat moves, but he's put everything he can into Jason in terms of choreography. I don't really think he can give Jason anything more, which is why Jason should probably move to a different choreographer. Another skater who just missed the podium, Han Yan of China, had a great short program, just really, really great stuff, even with the mistake on the combo. But, you know, he had issues in the free program, but I think fourth place is really good for Han because he's typically known as a skater who peaks later in the season. You know, we saw him take bronze last year at Four Continents. His skating skills, I could watch him skate for hours. He definitely does remind me of Patrick Chan in terms of just his seamlessness and his flow and his carriage across the ice. It's just really, really great to see. What are your guys' thoughts on Han Yan?
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Han Yan. I actually think I'm not the biggest fan of his short program as of right now. I mean, I think it's a good effort, but right now it comes off as a little bit awkward. If you're going to do sing, 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 please commit to the character like a Jeremy Abbott would. But I do think the long program has potential, and I think it could go somewhere. And also, I just want to say, his triple axle, it's amazing. Just not only the height, but the distance it gets. It covers so much ice just from one jump, and it's so impressive. I really enjoy his skating. I think his flow is excellent across the ice and how smooth everything looks. I just think it's getting that consistency. And I think that later on in the season, we will see him looking a lot better than he did here.
Yeah, for me personally, I like his skating. I like his skating skills. I like his jumps when they work really well. I just wish he would get into the program even more. He got, the second or third highest component marks. So, I was just hoping I would see more of a program from him, But, like, his overall skating is very good. And I think he'll continue to grow as an artist, hopefully as the years go on.
And the fifth and sixth place finishers, interestingly enough, here at Skate America were two Russian men, Konstantin Menshov and Adrian Pitkeyev. Both of them putting together two pretty strong programs. You know, I think Menshov is sort of relying on those quads to get him by. As we saw, he executed a nice short program, but those component scores still brought him down. I think Pitkeyev, on the other hand, he has the technique. He's a little bit more inconsistent than Menshov, but he has the technique and he has the full package. He's certainly one of my favorite Russian men to watch. I really liked his long program, especially. He finished fourth in that segment of the competition. What are you guys' thoughts on the two Russian men?
I agree with you. Menshov is very much relying on his quads to get by. However, I do think that he does pay attention to his music for the most part. I do think the long program is a good fit for him, especially the beginning part. However, I do think he's one that could, if he gets consistent, he could do well, but right now I don't see him in the top echelon of Russian skaters. Especially when you compare him to someone like Adrian Pitkeyev, who really, like, right, he's a bit more introverted. He reminds me a bit of Satoko Miyahara, mm-hmm. and that she has that quiet artistry, and I think Adrian is the same way. He does need to work more on projecting outward to the audience, but he is very nice. He is very easy and pleasant to watch, and he does have the technique, and I think in the future he is going to be the leader of Russian men skating.
Yeah, I personally feel like Menshov is past his prime. Like, I feel like he's definitely relying on those quads. And if it, for some reason, he can keep it in the short, but keep his mind in the short, but really struggle in the long program. And I question his future, especially if he can't keep a consistent balance between the short and the long program. But Adrian is definitely the future of Russian skating. And if he just continues to skate clean as the seasons go on, leading up to the next Olympics, I could see him just being up there.
For sure. You know, also in the Skate America men's field, we saw great performances from skaters like Ross Miner and Brendan Carey, who was great. I think he really has that technique locked up. He just needs to focus on getting more experience and getting more consistent, which, you know, will come with time. But, you know, as we've seen this pattern with Dennis Ten finishing ninth here, unfortunately, his coach Frank Carroll mentioned that he had been injured and just was not feeling 100%. And your heart went out to him in the free program. He really looked like he was struggling. But, you know, honestly, I don't think this is a major glitch for Dennis Ten because it's funny, he did get an Olympic and a world medal before he got his first Grand Prix medal of bronze last year at Trophy Eric Bompard. But yeah, I just think he just needs to go home, withdraw from his second Grand Prix. I think that will definitely suit him if he did that. And, you know, just rest and really take it easy for the rest of until his nationals and four continents. What do you guys think of Ten and the other men in the field?
Yeah, I feel like Dennis's injury is the biggest factor in his low placement and all his struggles here. I think that he is definitely someone who can be better later in the season, but I completely agree that he needs to withdraw from his second Grand Prix event if he's in the same shape as he was here. Mm-hmm. I think he just needs to recover from his injury because I think especially his long program, is going to be fabulous come Worlds. I think it's going to be an excellent program for him. And I think that when he is feeling better, we will see the Dennis we are used to.
And Dennis is one of those skaters that peaks later in the season. Like when it comes to four continents and world championships, he's in his prime condition. So it didn't really surprise me too much that he struggled here at Skate America. I think it was just another event to really just put out his programs. But he seems to be like one of those skaters that seems to every season peak at the right time. So I think this is just a fluke of a competition for him, and that it'll just get better with as the season goes on, because that's kind of how Dennis Ten is known for in the skating world right now.
For sure. Well, I think we're all set. What a great recap this was.
That was a fun recap. I had a great time. Well, thank you, Kanishka, for coming on the show. We really appreciate it, and you were a joy to talk to.
Thank you. It was my pleasure.
All right. You can follow us on Twitter, as always, at Lutz and Glory. You can read our blog at lutzandglory.blogspot.com. All right. I'm Bronwyn.
I'm Will.
And it was great talking to you guys. Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.